Hello everyone, in our practical sessions related to pharmaceutical analysis, today we are going to discuss about preparation and standardization of KMnO4 solution. So what will be the objective? The objective is to prepare and standardize 100 ml of 0.02 normal KMnO4 solution using sodium oxalate as a primary standard. What are the materials required for the practicals? The apparatus which are required are funnel, volumetric flask, conical flask, volumetric pipette, graduated pipette, burette, burette stand, rubber bulb, water bath, tripod stand and weighing balance. The chemicals which are required are KMnO4, the sodium oxalate and the sulfuric acid. Coming to the theory behind the practical. The practical is based upon the redox titration. And the redox titration is based on the change in electrode potential of the sample during the redox reaction. The oxidation is the loss of electron or the increase in oxidation number, and the reduction is the gain of electrons or the decrease in oxidation number. So what is an electrode potential? Electrode potential is the tendency of element for loss or gain of electrons when element is in contact with its ion. And it is calculated by using Nernst equation. And according to Nernst equation, E is equal to E naught plus RT upon NF and log value of the concentration of the oxidizing and the reducing species, where E is the electrode potential, E naught is the standard electrode potential, and N is the number of electrons gained or lost. Another important part of the theory is permagnetometry. What is permagnetometry? In this titration, KMnO4 solution is used as titrant and it is a self-indicator and an oxidizing agent. Permagnetometry is a part of redox titration. In this titration, KMnO4 solution is used as titrant and this is an oxidizing agent. This is a separate kind of titration, as we have already discussed about acid-based titration, iodometry, precipitation, etc. type of titration. So this is also a separate type of titration method. And KMnO4 gives different reaction with reducing agent in acidic, basic and neutral medium. So let's discuss what will happen. KMnO4 can break down in a solution to give two ions. KMnO4 will give K plus MnO4 minus ion. This MnO4 minus in acidic medium will form the Magnus ion, that is the Mn2 plus ion. In the basic medium, this MnO4 minus ion will form the magnate ion, that is MnO4 2 minus. And in the neutral medium, this MnO4 minus ion will form the manganese dioxide, that is MnO2. So it is important to note that KMnO4 solution is unstable in acidic and basic medium. So the KMnO4 solution must be prepared in neutral medium, that is with distilled water, which must be free from any kind of impurities. Then it is boiled for 15 to 20 minutes and cooled at room temperature, and finally filtered and used for titration. It is also important here that KMnO4 is used as self indicator. It will produce a pink color at the end point, so there is no need to add any kind of indicator in this standardization procedure. Coming to the procedure, and in first step we can prepare the KMnO4 solution. And for the preparation of KMnO4 solution, we can weigh the particular gram of the KMnO4 which we can further see in the calculation part, and we can dissolve it in the distilled water, and the volume is made up to the 100 ml. In the second step, we can go for the preparation of 0.02 normal sodium oxalate solution, and for that also we can weigh the particular gram of the sodium oxalate, which we can see in the calculation part, was accurately weighed and dissolved in distilled water, and the volume is made up to the 100 ml. Now coming to the standardization of KM104 solution. 10 ml of the sodium oxalate solution and the 2.5 ml of 1 molar sulfuric acid were warmed. Why the sulfuric acid is taken? It is taken to provide the acidic medium. And both of these were warmed up to 60 to 70 degrees centigrade in a conical flask using water bath. To that, a solution of KM104 solution was added until the solution becomes just pink. The titration was performed 3 times along with the 3 blank titrations, and the volume of the KM104 solution used in the blank titration was subtracted from the titration volume of the KM104 to obtain the volume of KM104 solution for the calculation purpose. Now coming to the observation table, we can prepare 2 observation table, one for the titration of the sodium oxalate versus KM104 solution and another for the blank titration. So for titration of the sodium oxalate versus KM104 solution, we can prepare the volume of the sodium oxalate solution, which is 10 ml. Then we can quote the burette reading, the initial reading, the final reading, and the used volume of the KM104. When we can repeat the practical 3 times, then we can get 3 values A, B and C. We can calculate the average volume and we can get a value A here from the observation table number 1. Now for the blank titration, we can take the volume of the distilled water, which is also 10 ml, as we have taken the 10 ml volume of the sodium oxalate. Then for the burette reading, we can put the initial reading, the final reading, and we can get the used volume of the KM104 as X, Y and Z. We can calculate the average volume of the KM104 and we can get a value B here for the blank titration. Now coming to the calculation portion, and the calculation steps are divided into 2 steps. The first step is the calculation for weighing, in which we can first calculate the 0.02 normal sodium oxalate solution. The normality of the sodium oxalate is 0.02. The equivalent weight is equal to the molecular weight upon 2, and the volume is 100 ml. So we can put all the values in the formula and we can get what the amount of sodium oxalate we have to weigh. Now in the second step, we can calculate the calculation we can do for 0.02 normal KM104 solution. The normality of KM104 solution is 0.02, and the equivalent weight can be calculated by dividing the molecular weight with 5, and the volume of KM104 solution is 100 ml. So we can put all the values in the formula and we can get what the gram of KM104 can be weighed for preparation of the solution. Now the second part of the calculation is the calculation for standardization of KM104 solution, for which we can use the formula N1V1 is equal to N2V2. So for N1V1, we have N KM104 and V KM104 is equal to N2V2. For N2V2 we have N sodium oxalate and the V of the sodium oxalate. Here the volume of the KM104 is equal to the volume of the titration, the value of A, which we have obtained from the observation table number 1, minus the volume used in the blank titration, the value B, which we have obtained from the observation table number 2. Now the normality of sodium oxalate is 0.02 and the volume of the sodium oxalate is 10. For the calculation of the normality of a KM104, we can put all the values in the formula and we can get the normality of the KM104. The normality of the KM104 which we obtained can be reported in the result, that KM104 solution was prepared and found to be this normal. So this is all about the standardization and preparation of KMNO4 solution. Thank you for your time.